Hi everyone, this is Yvette from Together Sisters Create. I have another photo deck class that I am teaching at the Scrabble Cottage in Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, and this is in a second version that I created. This paper is Bow Bunny and it's called Altitude, and it could have been last year's or the year before. I'm just trying to use up my old stash, and I made the base out of black. This is a paper phenomenon project from Kathy King. It is photo decks, and there's photo deck 1, 2, and 3. They fit in houses, but I didn't make the houses. I just made the photo decks. And I am currently teaching this class at the Scrapbook Cottage, and I just wanted to show the ladies. I didn't have time to videotape it before my class last weekend, and I have a couple more classes coming up, so I wanted you guys to see how I matted mine. This is a project from Holiday Kit Club 4, and it was released in 2016. So I will start. All the photo decks measure 6 and 3/8, I think, yeah. And this was a 6 by 6 cutout from the paper, and then I matted it on a bit of white so that I don't have too much black showing. I did cut into this photo frame so that you can tuck your picture in there. I probably won't be able to, but anyways, I did leave it open that you can tuck your picture in there. And I just love making these. They were a lot of fun. Just gonna try and zoom in a little bit. So anyways, same as the last one, but I didn't put any glitter treatment on the spine or anything like that. This is the back. I love the good grain and the snowflakes. And it opens this way. And this is one of the 4x6 cutouts, and it says, let's build a snowman. The snowman's upside down. And then you've got two photo mats that fit 4x6, and here I chose to use some pattern paper. On the other one I didn't, but this, you can definitely put a photo or pattern paper. And here I did make the pockets, and I did change the size of this pocket. I think it's, I think it was 1/2 inch smaller. So this one is 2, so it's 2.5 with the hinge. And the reason I did that is so that this looks like a perfect 4x6. So if you don't want to use the pocket, then it looks like you just matted the bottom. But if you do want to put some ephemera in there or some extra little bits and pieces, then you can go ahead and put some in the pocket. So it's, I made this pocket 1/2 inch bigger, like longer. And then on this side, we have just pattern paper and photo mats, and here I chose to do the two pattern papers on top. The other one I did one on the bottom and one on top, so just showing you different options. Move it this way, and then in the center here we have photo mats, and here I chose to do a pattern paper, but you could also place a photo. And then there's a pocket on the back here. So this I fold inside so it keeps all the flaps down, and then I fold it this way. This is some ephemera that came with the kit. And then this is a 4x4, so my photo mat is 8 3/8 by 4 1/4. And then score it in half, and then you have room for both photos there. And then this is just all leftover pieces that I used for my photo mats. Flip it over, and we have another photo mat there. And here we have another journaling card. And you can open it this way and this way. And then you've got some more pattern paper here. You could do a photo there too if you want. Again, I chose to do a pocket on this one. And I did make it a little 1/2 inch wider so that it would cover, like it would just be longer here. And then some more ephemera from the paper collection. These are cutouts from the paper collection. And then this opens this way, and here I did some 3x4s, which I love to do, or 3x3s, which I love to do, and then there's room in the back there for you to put your photo in. And then this opens this way, And this one I chose to put the strip at the bottom. And then here's the belly band with some ephemera in there. And then you open up more photos. And here I did some banners. And there's, again, you can put your photos behind the banners. So I just stuck it on the edge here so that you can put your photos in there. And then pattern paper in the middle. So that is the first one. And I will show you the second one. Second one's really, really simple. It's, again, I chose to do some glitterets on the side here with some score tape. I had that in my stash from years ago, so, and then some elastic for the closure. And then I opened it up, and this one I did like Kathy Orta did, for Kathy King. She's got score tape here, and it does make it a lot stiffer, so, yeah. Give it a try if you want. It works really well. So here's just some photo mats. Again, leftover papers, and then I stuck them on there. Some journaling cards. This one is kind of cool. You can journal here, put your photo down there. And this one measures the top pieces for the whole piece is 10 and 3/8. And then you're going to score at 4 and an 8th, or a little bit more than 4 and an 8th. So anyways, that's another photo mat. And then this is another photo mat. So you open it this way, and then you've got a photo, and then you can journal there. This one measures 7 3/8. This is a 3x3 and a 3x4. And then we have another 4x6, a 3x4. This one's a 3x4 on top with a 4x6 at the bottom. This one measures 9 3/8. Put your photo, your mat, and then you can score appropriately, I think is what I did. And then some more. Journaling cards. I wanted to fill this centerpiece so that I can see how it's going to hold up. And then here's a 4x4 and a 4x6. Same thing, 4x4 and a 4x6. On this side we have a 3x4 and a 4x6. More 3x4s. Do it this way. 3x4s. This is a 4x4 and a 4x6. Left room for journaling and a photo. More 3x4s. Four by six with some pattern paper. This was a journaling card. This was a 6x6, and then I cut it down to a 4x6. This is a journaling card. 4x4, just chunks of paper left over, and another 4x4, and a 4x6. And then you just fold the flaps down, close it, and you can put the elastic band around there. And that's number two. So that's number two. Number three is, I have quite a few of these on my YouTube station. My YouTube channel, because I did a lot of these for Christmas last year. I made about 9 or 10 of them for my coworkers. So have a look at that. And this is number three. So the bottom is a kind of a 3D box. It's kind of one and two combined in three. So these are 3x4s. And again, I left some room for you to put the photo in. There's a flap here. This is a 3D pocket, so it's about 1/2 inch wide. Again, you can have lots of photo mats, and this is all made with the leftovers. And then there's a 3x3 in there, or 3x4. And then the flap closes. I use some ephemera from the die cut pieces from the paper collection. So that closes like that. Here I used some more pieces from the paper collection, die cuts. glue them down, and then that flips and flaps like that. And then the middle, we have, this is kind of number two, but connected to number one and number three, I guess. So here's a die cut that I just left in the, this is a die cut piece that came with the paper collection too. So I left it open so you can put a photo behind that. And then these are all 4x6s. So they're journaling cards, leftover papers. This one's a 3x4. And 4x6s, or 4x4 plus a 4x6, 4x4 with a 4x6, and a 4x4. So earlier in the video, I gave you the measurements for those. So just watch the beginning of the video and you'll see the measurements. And then I have the top version. The top version is a 3x4. Then it opens up, and then I have another journaling card here. And then I did a little flip so that you could journal here, put a photo there. A 4x4. The black, it measures 4 1/4 by 4 1/4. Your photo mat is 4x4. And then I have that here. Again, I left this open so that you can put stuff behind there. This is not a pocket, it's just a photo mat. Then we have that. We have this side that opens. Another photo mat here, and another flip here, and then an acetate pocket. And that is my photo deck number 3. It's done in the black cardstock with Bow Bunny Altitude, and these are all 3 of them. So I thank you all for taking my classes, for the ladies that did take my classes. I hope you enjoyed it. I certainly enjoyed having you in my classes. And I will see you guys again. And hopefully, there we go. It's a little bit better. And I will see you again for the Photofolio 1, which will start in November of 2017. So I will come back with a video with that when I have them finished. Thank you very much for watching, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye-bye.